G'day, my smart mates. My name's Dylan Dance. I'm a physicist from the land down under. Let's watch some Simpsons.
And this perpetual motion machine she made today is a joke. It just keeps going faster and faster.
I see these perpetual motion machines all over the internet, so I should probably say, according to our current understanding of physics, they're not possible. The first law of thermodynamics. You can't create, nor can you destroy energy. It can only change from one form to another. So for a perpetual motion machine, it's producing some work without energy input. It doesn't make any sense.
Lisa, get in here! In this house, we obey the laws of thermodynamics!
That's what we were just talking about.
I'm a nerd.
So am I!
Definitely a nerd. I remember seeing this in a physics meme, and they were claiming that the Simpsons predicted the mass of the Higgs boson, which is known as like the God particle. The mass was only fairly recently confirmed at the Large Hadron Collider, and this episode came out in like 1998. So people were, you know, doing that whole Simpsons predicted the future once again. If you look these numbers up and plug them into the equation, it predicts a mass of 775 giga electron volts, which is quite a bit higher than the estimate produced by the Large Hadron Collider back in 2012 when the particle was discovered, which is 125 giga electron volts. But that's pretty close in my opinion. So not a bad guess considering, you know, it's Homer and it was 14 years before physicists at CERN made those calculations. So you might have heard of the Higgs boson before, also known as the God particle. And people tend to think it's what gives everything mass. It's not quite true, it's the Higgs field that gives all the other elementary particles their mass. But it's actually not where most of the mass comes from. Most of the mass comes from protons and nuclei binding together. Still a mystery why some elementary particles interact more with the Higgs field than others, we don't quite know, so that's just another reason to get involved in science. The Higgs field is like an invisible field that permeates all space, and the Higgs bosons are like the quanta of energy of this Higgs field. So they're like the little building blocks of the field. They're not quite particles, because in quantum field theory, this Higgs field is a quantum field, there's no particles. We often refer to them as particles, but we don't actually mean particles. So it gets a bit confusing. What we mean when we say particles is like, you know, some of this field coalesced into this small little region. So it's more like a wave. It's not really a particle. And we haven't used that idea for a long time, but we still say particles. Where does the Higgs field come from? We have no flipping idea. What we currently think is that shortly after the Big Bang, particles had no mass. Everything was massless, and you had this hot primordial soup, is what we say. And then, spontaneously, this Higgs field turned on. Why did it turn on? If you can answer that, you'll probably win a Nobel Prize. But anyway, let's keep watching The Simpsons.
Very good. That is really... dog in box. Genius.
I was going to say, it's not that funny. So what it says is today's math joke, the square root of negative 1 is I, imaginary number, 2 to the power of 3 is 8, and you've got the sum of pi. So it's saying I ate some pi, and it was delicious. I'm pretty sure one of the creators of this show is meant to be a mathematician, so that explains this math joke and some of the other super nerdy things like the Higgs boson equation.
I wrote this poem for you. It's called Cat Math. 4 paws plus 1 tail plus 9 lives equals 1 special cat.
Let's confirm that. 4 legs, 1 tail, 1 special cat. Calculations work out. Can't not get my cat when cats and math are mentioned.
Pish posh, Professor. What makes a guy and a girl click isn't science, it's chemistry.
Which is science.
What?
Which is easy physics. So, if you want to get girls, get good at physics.
Homer's scientific research can solve anything, except for cold fusion, quasars, the interior of black holes, and what preceded the Big Bang. But everything else...
Hold up. We've pretty much solved quasars. We know what they are. Cold fusion, yeah, we're still a while off that. I think we'll solve it though. Science has got that one. The interiors of black holes, that one could be the trickiest. I still think science can help us out there though. We just need a black hole to experiment with. The before the Big Bang, well, yeah, that one's a big ask, but again, it's possible. And Roger Penrose actually did some speculation recently after he won that Nobel Prize in physics. And he proposed that there was just more universe before the Big Bang. And the universe is this cyclical thing where it eventually gets to this stage where everything dies off. And that's what we think will currently happen in our universe. In the far distant future, everything, there'll be nothing. Everything will be moving so far apart as space is expanding at an accelerating rate. You won't even have black holes or stars because everything is expanding and getting further apart. So eventually, all the galaxies will die. They'll stop producing stars. And eventually, all the black holes will evaporate because of Hawking radiation. And you'll have nothing. And at this point, Penrose suggests that it's kind of like the same as having nothing. So somehow, the universe will be reborn. I don't know. He compares it to the size of a photon because a photon size isn't well defined. It's kind of zero, and zero is kind of the same as like infinity. So yeah, science, I think, can solve all of those problems.
Behold gravity in all its glory!
Pretty lame, Milhouse.
That's exactly what I say when I'm in an elevator and it comes to stop.
Professor, don't be offended. Do you think it might be your voice?
Why, what's wrong with my voice? With the up and down and the extra words and the terminal nonsense and the hiving, cliving, wagging? Oh my God, it's the voice.
Duh.
Is that how I speak? Let me know down in the comments if I have a nerdy voice.
Hey, Flanders, heading for church? Well, I thought I could save you a little time.
Ooh!
I accidentally proved there's no God.
We'll just see about that. Uh-oh. Well, maybe he made a mistake. Nope. It's airtight. Can't let this little doozy get out.
That's hilarious. Don't know what to say about that. Could you imagine if we were actually able to do that? I don't actually think anything would change. We already live in like an alternative facts reality, so I'm pretty sure everyone would just continue doing their thing and wouldn't even give it a second thought.
To the museum. Evolution. How can you put up an exhibit on the origin of man and not have one mention of the Bible?
Oh, we do.
Most cherished beliefs a myth?
Daddy, was Mommy a monkey? I can't remember.
No one was ever a monkey. Everything is what it was and always will be. God put us here and that's that.
But you said a stork brought me.
Yeah, that was God disguised as a stork.
Who brings baby storks?
There's no such thing as storks. It's all God.
Please bless Daddy.
Stop.
We're still monkeys, by the way. We're just some smart primates. Or maybe just an advanced lemur. Who knows?
I don't know which is a bigger disappointment. My failure to formulate a unified field theory, or you.
So what he means there is by the unified field theory is our current best series, quantum field theories, which are field theories, and the best one is the standard model, but these field theories don't incorporate gravity whatsoever. They incorporate the other three fundamental forces, but they just leave out gravity. So a unified field theory would bring together general relativity and quantum mechanics, because general relativity is all about gravity. Quantum mechanics is very small stuff. Better than Iron Man, because Iron Man was meant to be like an engineer. So that's the physicist version of the Iron Man.
Are we going to do any actual math problems?
Problems?
That's how men see math, something to be attacked, to be figured out.
But isn't it? I mean, confidence building can't replace real learning.
Uh-oh, Lisa. Sounds like you're trying to derail our self-esteem engine.
Right, well, that's a little bit sexist, but there's definitely not enough females in physics. So if you're a female out there and you want to go into physics, you definitely should. Some of the best physicists and mathematicians in history have been female, so we need more of them in. All right, that'll do it for today's video. Clearly, if you want to write a good show, you need some math geeks, because I just did some research and a whole bunch of the writers are mathematical heavyweights. A few of them have PhDs, a few have gone to Harvard to study math, so there you go. If you want to write a good show, go study math. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video, and I'll catch you guys next time.